They are a precious resource in and around Dane County, around the world. But right now there is a group working very hard to be very good stewards of our area waterways, specifically our lakes. We see James Tai here every week. He's been sneaking in more and more water-related events. I don't know if you've been able to tell lately, but he is back with us today solely to talk about a cause near and dear to his heart and his work right now, the Clean Lakes Alliance. James, yes. Thanks for being with us.
My pleasure.
You know, I've been teasing you all summer. I'm like, a lot of water-related events.
Yes.
On this week's calendar, but there's a reason for that. Talk about the organization you have gotten very involved in.
Yeah, so it's the Clean Lakes Alliance, which is the group that's sort of spearheading the effort along with the county to finally, once and for all, take care of the water quality problems that we have of our lakes.
People like to complain about, you know, the LG or, you know, whatever it is, maybe not using certain fertilizers on their lawns, but there's a real need for this,
yeah,
isn't there?
There's a big need. We live in a watershed, so basically all the water around in our communities actually ends up in our lakes. Milwaukee is completely different. There, if you put something on your lawn or on your driveway, it actually goes through a stormwater system and is treated, and then it goes back into Lake Michigan. Here, when you put something on the ground, whether it's on a farm or at the gas station or the car wash or your dog waste, if you don't take care of it, it goes directly into our lakes.
Which is why we see some of the issues that we have every
exactly.
year.
Exactly.
A lot is being done. This is a public-private
yes.
partnership. You've got, you know, you mentioned the county. You've got a lot of people rallying around this.
Yeah, we've
right
got
now.
A lot of partners, and we've formed some great new relationships with the Madison Metropolitan Sewer District, with many different communities around the area, trying to figure out how the best ways to take care of this, because it's just not one person's problem. It's a community thing. But our lakes are our number one resource in our community. The reason the state capital is here is because of the lakes. The lakes are more important than the Badgers, you know, for those poor people. It's more important than the state capital, even more important than the university. Because if the lakes go bad, we're all in trouble.
All right. So there have been a lot of events happening in order to support this cause. But this weekend, it's a Celebrate the Lakes. Talk about the event going on.
Yeah, this is the idea that, you know what, the lakes are really for everybody. And there are lots of different things you can do on the lakes to have fun, from sailing to water skiing. And this is a one-day, one-stop shop. So you can come to Olin Turville Park this Saturday. And we've got a great list of wonderful events to do. Everything from learning how to water ski to log rolling, paddle boring, kayak canoeing. We even have a liquid courage run, which actually is a 2 miles or obstacle course that ends with a slip and slide. There's also a heritage tour on the lake, so you actually can go on and learn about the history of our lakes, some of the geology and the ecology of lakes. So it's a fun-filled day of activities. Some are small fee, but a lot of them are free. Got some great music there. I think you might be performing there on Saturday at about 7 o'clock.
We are.
Yeah.
We are. Couple of us.
So it's a great day. Lots of food, beverages, and a great day to spend right there on Olin.
Get out and enjoy it and support a great cause at the same time. James, great to see you.
My pleasure.
Thanks so much for being here. A final check on your traffic and your forecast when we come back.